The Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God,
begotten of his Father before all worlds,
God of God, light of light,
very God of very God,
begotten, not made,
being of one substance with the Father,
by whom all things were made,
who for us men and for our salvation
came down from heaven,
was incarnate by the Holy Spirit
of the Virgin Mary,
and was made man,
and was crucified also for us
under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered and was buried,
and the third day he rose again according to the scriptures,
and ascended into heaven,
and sits at the right hand of the Father,
and he will come again with glory
to judge both the living and the dead,
whose kingdom will have no end.
And I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord and giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
with the Father and the Son together
is worshipped and glorified,
who spoke by the prophets.
I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church.
I acknowledge one baptism
for the remission of sins.
And I look for the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
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 Thank you.
Well, hello everybody at Trinity Lutheran Church and School. This is Pastor Chuck, and I'm here to do your Maundy Thursday chapel service. Now, quick quiz I want to ask you guys is, why in the world do we call it Maundy Thursday? Why don't we just call it Thursday? Why don't we just say Thursday before Easter? Well, simply enough, if we want to look at it, it's more complicated for the people in Old Church than it is New Church. But the word Maundy actually means, in the Latin, it means the command. So when you say the command on Thursday, what does that actually mean? Well, I want to read it to you because this is referring to something really cool in the book, in the book of Matthew. The book of Matthew says this in chapter 22, and it says these words, "And Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all of your heart and with all of your soul and with all of your mind. This is the first and greatest command." See, guys, the word Maundy means the command of Thursday. And this is a day of love. This is where our Heavenly Father is literally commanding us to do what we're supposed to do in this greatest of all commandments found in the book of Matthew. So, your friends, your family, your siblings, all those people that you know, even the ones that pick on you and the ones that you might pick on, today is the day that we reach out to them and we extend that love that we know that our Heavenly Father is asking us. So what in the world goes on Maundy Thursday? Because Maundy Thursday, when it comes to the whole Easter season, it's one of those days. We got Good Friday. We also have Easter. And Maundy Thursday just seems kind of like the extra day that it begins with. Well, here, I want to show you is that we have some things that are here on this altar with me right now. Because if you go to a Maundy Thursday service at your church, you'll see the pastor doing this very important thing. So, I have in front of me a bunch of wafers, and I also have a common cup. For many churches, they also use a bunch of individual cups. Now, what this is called, it's called the Eucharist, or it's called communion. And on Maundy Thursday, that's one of the things that we do on this service, is we know it's the greatest command is to love, but it is also the time that we reflect and see how the disciples came together with Jesus shortly before he was caught by the Romans and brought to the trial. It's known as the Last Supper. So Jesus, he's sitting here and he's getting ready to eat, and his disciples to the left of him and to the right of him, they're all around there and they're talking and they're having a good old time. And literally Jesus looked at him as they were talking, and he picked up a piece of bread. And the piece of the bread, he looked at him and he said, well, after giving thanks, of course, naturally enough, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples and said, take and eat. This is my body. Now that's kind of weird. The disciples had no idea what that meant at the time. It wasn't until after Easter and after the Holy Spirit came upon them that they learned what that meant. But they knew at that one moment, as Jesus is doing the Last Supper and he's handing out the elements, the wafers, and he's saying, take and eat, this is my body. This is something special. So the next thing as he did is he took the wine. And after taking the wine, he looked up to the Heavenly Father and he said, I want to give thanks for all which I've been given. And then he looked at his disciples. He looked at Peter. He looked at John. He looked at Matthew. He looked at Thomas. And literally, he handed him this cup and he said, take and drink. This is the New Testament of my blood shed for you, forgiveness of all of your sins. This do as often as you can in remembrance of me. The disciples, they took this cup, and they were relaxing, having a lot of fun, sitting there and eating. But when Jesus did these special things purely out of grace and out of love, he was telling his disciples that every time that you come to the Lord's table, even after when I'm gone, Because we know what happens when it comes to Good Friday and Easter, right, guys? Jesus gets caught by the Romans. Then Jesus gets put on trial. Jesus is found guilty. And then he goes to be crucified. He dies. He is buried. And then our Heavenly Father raises him from the dead. So all that is going on. And quickly enough, when Jesus comes back from the dead, he spends 40-some days with the disciples talking with them. And all that time, he's saying, hey, guys, remember that time where we did the Last Supper together? I want you guys to always do that with me in remembrance of me. So when you find new people, so Thomas and Matthew and John, when you guys have new friends and you're talking about me, I want you to do communion with them. I want you to, in remembrance of me, knowing that this is my body, these little wafers is my body, and that this wine is my blood. And I want you to partake of my body and my blood, because what my sacrifice is here today is purely grace and purely forgiveness. Now, you guys might ask yourself, what does the word grace mean? Some people say that grace is mercy. Well, then what's mercy? Well, here's the thing I like thinking about. So imagine you're at school, and we were trying to figure out what the word grace means and what the word mercy means. So imagine if you were at school, and you're on the playground, and you got one kid who's really mean. The teachers don't know what's going on, and this one kid comes by and pushes all the other kids down, gets everyone upset at this kid, and this kid is downright just mean. Well, one day, this other kid, he goes and he goes to this kid and says, hey, I want you to stop to do what you're doing. Well, that mean kid, because that kid stood up to him, kind of gets angry and he starts pushing him around. But because that one kid stood up to him and did that, even though that big angry kid eventually was able to push him down, the big angry kid looks at him and says, you know, there's something about you. You stood up to me, so I'm going to have mercy on you because you did something, so I'm going to spare you any more of my angry stuff. Now, the word grace is a little bit different. Imagine that bully, that person who's really mean and he's picking on everybody, and as he's picking on everybody, that same kid who came up and said, hey, knock it off, I want you to stop and do what you're doing. And that bully keeps on doing it. He keeps on pushing the kid who tells him to stop. And then that one kid who said, knock it off and stop, he actually makes the bully stop and pushes him down the ground and says, I want you to stay and stop picking on everybody. So the bully turns around and says, okay, I won't do these things. And so what does he do? He turns around, and as the good kid is saying, okay, I trust you, he turns his back on him, and the bully picks up a big rock and throws it and hits the kid in the back of the head. Well, the word grace, guys, means is the action that the kid who just got hit in the back of the head is going to do. Because that kid who just got hit in the back of the head, he should be like, hey, I'm going to beat you up. Or, hey, I can't believe you did this. You are just a jerk. Well, instead, that kid, by all manner of everything is, he says he could have done anything he wanted. He looks at the bully and says, I forgive you, even though you do not deserve it. So grace is undeserved, and mercy is deserved. Okay, so going back to everything I was talking about here today, guys, I hope you guys have a wonderful Maundy Thursday. And I hope when you guys go to church and you can witness this, because a lot of you younger kids, you can't do communion yet. You can't do the communion yet because, you know, you got to go through confirmation first so you can understand what it's all about. But just remember, Jesus was there with his disciples. And the first time he did this, he literally gave them bread and wine. And he said, from now on, whenever you do this, I will be there. I will be that bread. I will be that wine. And I want you to share this awesome gift with as many people as possible. All right. Well, I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and God bless.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.